अब मुझे किसी प्रकार का टेंशन नहीं है यहाँ पर रह करके। लेकिन यहाँ पर आकर के एक सुकून सा है कि चलो अब मुझे कुछ करना नहीं है, यहाँ शांति से है। अपने हस्बैंड सुबह जाते हैं शाम को आते हैं।
मेरे अकॉर्डिंग तो मुझे लगता है कि सब कुछ बेस्ट ही है, पानी की कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, इलेक्ट्रिसिटी की कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है।
The joy and pride of owning a house. Thousands of low-income households across India are now feeling financially empowered to secure a home for themselves. From Pune to Ahmedabad to the National Capital Region, we came across many success stories of low-income families who are experiencing what it means to have the biggest security in life, a home.
इतनी कम बजट में और जो 56 फिट स्क्वायर फिट है, तो उसके अकॉर्डिंग यहाँ पे जो भी इन्होंने मॉडल किचन दी है ओपन, वो बेस्ट है।
Today, a number of developers across parts of India are providing one-bedroom flats in well-planned group housing societies for just under 10 lakhs.
दिवाली पे हम दीवार पे लिखते हैं शुभ लाभ, तो उसी कड़ी में हमने ये प्रण लिया कि चलो भाई अब काम जो करेंगे वो लाभ के साथ साथ शुभ भी हो।
Dinesh Nagar on the NH24 near Ghaziabad is one such project developed by the Garg Group.
A roof over the head and the dignity of shelter. Every Indian's dream is to live in a home that they can call their own. Projects like Dinesh Nagar are touching the lives of many low-income families and just goes to prove that yes, low-income housing is possible and can be made successful.
Starting from 7.99 lakhs to just over 10 lakhs, flats are available in this range with one bedroom, an open kitchen, living room, bath and toilet and a balcony. Also part of the package, reliable power and water supply, sewerage, paved roads, 24/7 security, lush green parks and commercial developments. Nationalized lenders like SBI and PNB, along with a number of microfinance companies, are actively disbursing loans to these low-income families. But achieving this mean feat of making homes under 10 lakhs was fraught with many challenges.
If you see this road, this is a 70 feet wide road. Now, for a project like this with small houses, why do you need a 70 feet wide road? But it's in the book, so you have to go by the book. If I do my premium housing segment, the FAR that I get is 2. And if I purchase it, it goes up to 2.753. For affordable housing scheme, the FAR is 1.75.
The developer also lobbied to get the country's biggest public sector lender, SBI, to tweak its credit norms when lending to the low-income customers of Dinesh Nagar.
Banks should be mandated to do such kind of projects as a housing loan. Otherwise, the lower level staff maybe, they are not interested in 4 lakh rupee loan, 5 lakh rupee, they have to do 1-5.
In Ahmedabad, the environment for low-income housing is much more robust. Foliage Real Estate Developers builds group housing flats of an average size of 400 square feet in the 3 to 10 lakh range under the Navjeevan brand.
We've got customers from all sorts of backgrounds. You know, we've got gardeners, we have got, this day hawkers, we have got self-employed tailors, we have got self-employed garage owners, and of course, people who have stable incomes from industries who have been working for companies, you know, earning 15,000, 20,000 are also our customers.
Pune-based developer Vastu Shodh Projects has also touched many lives with its CRISIL-rated low-income housing project, Anand Gram at Yavat.
We offer one-room kitchen, one-bedroom and two-bedroom houses for the lower strata of the society, the bottom of the pyramid, we call it. These houses cost anything between 3.5 lakhs to 15 lakhs, and it has large open spaces. Community living amenities like amphitheaters, playgrounds have techniques.
These developers are leading a silent resurgence in the low-income housing market with their profitable models. But despite their triumphant stories, this is still just a drop in the ocean. Our cities remain mute spectators to their slumification, and while those get regularized, serious players continue to battle lazy bureaucracy and redundant housing norms. Vasudha Sharma, NDTV.